3 o'clock today. Welcome everybody to the live stream from the Oswego Comic Shop with me, Aaron Z. Lee. What is the date today? July 1st. July 1st, 2020. Comic Shop. Live stream. If you want to check out more of my stuff, you can always check out Pens and Pedals on Instagram, or you can go to pensandpedals.com. That's my website. I've got some stuff up there as well. Just some housekeeping stuff to begin with. If you'd like to check out some more of my work or buy any of my books, I've got Was It the Robot number 1 that's available at the Oswego Comic Shop. And I've got Was It the Robot number 3 that's available at the Oswego Comic Shop. Number 2 might be sold out. If you're interested in doing in getting an issue 3, we might be able to start like a pre-order to do a reprint of issue number 3. There's also the fully collected edition of my comic book Preacher's Pizza. I think we've got 1 copy left at the Oswego Comic Shop, but I'm gonna look at the inside of that. Black and white artwork on both. I like the look of the black and white artwork. Maybe color eventually, who knows? Thanks, Brian. Nice to see you in the mix here. My dog Tootsie is hanging out in my studio here. She was chasing a ball, now she's just chillaxing. A couple other things going on today. The comic shop is doing a giveaway of the Negan Lives comic book that's being distributed. I think it's in shops right now. Negan Lives, The Walking Dead. So, if you guys are interested in getting a giveaway of the Negan Lives Walking Dead comic book, if you're in the chat and you write the name of my dog Tootsie in there, you can be chosen by a very important member of the team here to receive your free copy of The Walking Dead Negan Lives. So, if that's something you're interested in, you can just throw Tootsie in the chat. Yeah, I've been saying Negan went on sale today, so it's in the shop. So, to celebrate the return of The Walking Dead, and it's also really cool that Robert Kirkman and Charlie Adlard are releasing that at 100% profit to the comic shops because of all this COVID stuff. So, I know I did just draw Wesley really quick, but today what I'm going to be doing, is doing some zombie artwork. And I, you know, being an artist who's into comic books, got some older artwork that I did that features some zombies. There's an 11x17 printout of that from ways back in the day, but that's done, so I don't need to work on that. Also, I started working on this last week. I worked on it a little bit more. It's a little Wolverine multimedia piece. It's got colored pencil, watercolor, and I started to use the Dr. P.H. Martin's inks that my wife got me probably like 10 years ago, and I'm finally getting to them now, but man, are they vibrant. Look at that. Got a good glossiness, too. Yeah, so this will be a fun one to finish up. It's kind of fun to play with all the materials. I've been doing ink for so long. It's nice to play around with some other materials as well. But the thing I'm going to be working on first, and we'll see if I get through this, we'll start working on something else, too. But I've got some zombie artwork that I started, I don't even know when I started it, a while ago, that needs some color. So, I think I'm going to start with some watercolor, and maybe I'll pull in some Dr. P.H. Martin inks. You know what, maybe I'll just go straight to the Dr. P.H. Martin inks. I'm glad that our follower, Ryan, is following some stuff in this stream that he's enjoying. That's good. Thanks for being here. You know what? I'm just gonna go nuts. They have like a super vibrant magenta. I'm just going to throw that in the background because I like it. Okay, and the music I'm playing in the background is some tracks I made, like, geez, maybe 10 years ago. I did start playing around with some new music. I made a couple new tracks. They're definitely incomplete, but I put them in the mix here, too. The one I like the most is, tried to rip off Blue Monday by New Order. Returning to some more traditional work in the future. Started laying out some pages for some new Wes of the Robot comics today. Gotta start digging into them because they are. I've been saying Martin's glad, he'd be glad I'm putting some pink in here. You know, I'm just gonna start off with the pink and yellow and then we'll return back to it. I'll grab some of that Dr. P.H. Martin's yellow and put it in here too. Yeah, the Asuka Comic Shop are the best. I go in there. I picked up Copra, the book by Michelle Fife. I've been really getting into that recently. It's kind of like a Suicide Squad done by all one guy. And I haven't really read Suicide Squad, but I like Michelle Fife's take on it, kind of like an Ecstatics. Like if you remember the Peter Milligan and Mike Allred run on X-Force. It's got that kind of vibe with the mercenaries where you don't know who's going to make it, who's going to stay in the book, who's going to be a permanent character. You just don't know. I like using the brush better than the eyedropper. It has more control. Suckered in by how vibrant this magenta is. All these inks are super vibrant. And they hold up after 10 years, so there you go. Dr. P.H. Martin's. I didn't even know if Michaels carries those. You can definitely get it on Amazon if you're interested in some Dr. P.H. Martin. I'm using this brush called a dagger brush. These are pretty cool. Because you can get very thick lines and thin lines. You do a lot with one brush. I'm a fan. Digging through my old portfolios, I find a bunch of fan art that's black and white art, but not colored. Might start bringing those into the stream. Make some dedicated time to get those colored in. I started some Stranger Things artwork way back in the day, I think like during season one. Had put in a few characters, never finished it up, but I liked where it was going. Maybe that'll make a return. And that's not something I'm hoping to hold on to, so if somebody was interested in that, I'd probably let that go. haven't tested out yet with the Dr. P.H. Martin inks is that they're not reactivated by water, so that means once this dries, I can go in with another Dr. P.H. Martin right over the top, and I don't have to worry about it blending, which is kind of cool. Send it to Joe so he can use it on some other streams. I've not done that yet, but I didn't forget. I just didn't do it yet. Got some more people chiming in with, keyword to get the free Negan Lives book. Glad that people are playing that game. If you don't play, you can't win. Makes me want to start working on some traditional inks again. I was doing a lot of digital stuff just because it's so convenient. Evan wants to work on some music stuff. I did get my little MIDI controller, my Akai MIDI controller, out of the basement today because I've been trying to clean up and organize. I've been getting a little bit done here and there. Between taking Tootsie for a walk and going swimming and reading Copra. Some more of those gigantic Sharpies too. Those are a lot of fun to work with. I can tell that I colored in a lot of these figures, the lower half of them, with Sharpie because the ink is different. And on the rest, I think I used a brush pen for the rest. Kind of doing some Halloween in July type stuff right now. I do have another character that I'm eventually going to be putting together into like a one-man anthology book, Creep of the Crop. I did some Inktober comics with that character. Basically a boogeyman who lives in farmland. And he's going to be like a crypt keeper with some other stories in there. I've got some ideas, but I just haven't tackled them all yet. I've got at least one more story to wrap up. Maybe I'll do that this October, or do it ahead of time and then roll it out in October. That sounds like a smarter idea. Because school will be back on and everything in the swing of things. Evan says he has an Akai Mini MPK. He swapped it out for an M-Audio code 49 during quarantine. I think that means 49 key. I had an M-Audio 49 key thing, but like, I'm not really a piano player, and I didn't need that much, or that many keys, because I just kind of plunk around and create melodies. Who knows, maybe someday I'll change my mind, but so far no regrets on that front. Because the Akai is pretty good. Just plunking around and making some melodies, trying to get more minimal. I used to try and play more guitar and bass and other instruments into songs, but now I just fully embrace the electronic part of it because I don't need anything else. I don't have to worry about it. Everything is complete all in the one set. I would like to record from my iPad into that, but I just haven't looked into the equipment I would need to record that. Because they have the Moog free iPad app where you can simulate the Moog sounds right on your iPad, and they've got some great bass tones. It'd be fun to play around with that. Fun to draw horror characters, because they don't have to be perfect. You can kind of get into some of the gruesome details of it. Got a whole book of B-movie posters, B-horror movie posters. Really cool stuff. Movie posters, I mean, Photoshop is great and all, but before Photoshop, I think movie posters were a lot better, because you used to have amazing movie posters for movies that were not so great. And I feel like now we have not so great movie posters for movies that are great. Outside of a few notable exceptions. Evan says he used to play some guitar and put that in songs as well. I think I've got some old examples of songs somewhere where I put some guitar work in. I'll dig those up. That's another thing I want to do, is organize all my files this summer. A lot of stuff. I'll just try to overbook everything. Just gotta make like a couple goals a day, try and get them done. Since he works exclusively off of BeatMaker 3 a DAW on iPad. I haven't used that a lot. I've used Fruity Loops, I think, has an Apple app now. I've played around with that a little bit. I think I have Fruity Loops on my phone. I mostly just use Fruity Loops. Use that since like high school. Just something that I took the time to learn and haven't done a ton in other places. Although I would like to get some new VST plugins, I think, when I think of it. But my current thing is I bought some packs, not for music, but for art, for retro coloring. So it uses those halftone dots in the CMYK, like cyan, magenta, yellow, and black, like the printing colors. Create that retro look, and I'm slowly figuring out how to install them, how to use them. We'll put them to work once I get it going. It's rather involved. It's not as simple as I might have thought. And I also have been collecting some different books that are colored using different mechanical processes, like some old Kamiko books that were printed with like 100% flat color in their color, so their color is very vibrant. So I'm thinking about like just literally sampling up large areas of color from different books, or even halftones or textures, and just bringing those into my books, or at least the covers. Maybe eventually the interiors, but I like the look of the black and white as well. So I'd be happy if they just stayed black and white. Alright. Yeah, it looks pretty good on screen. That kind of like scratchy brush in the back looks alright. I have, Evan says, like a digital Zipitone or strictly CMYK coloring. It's the packs that I bought are CMYK color, but I have a bunch of digital Zipitone too. And Clip Studio has it built right into the software. You can do it, but I've got it for Procreate. I've got a ton of Zipitone brushes for Photoshop, and some Zipitone for Affinity Photo. I don't use a ton of Photoshop anymore, just because I'm trying to veer off of that, so I don't have to pay Adobe so much money. And Affinity is a good software. I really like the drawing in their Affinity Photo. I think they do a nice job. All right, let's see. We'll wait for the outside to dry, but while we're doing that, maybe we'll grab... I got some white. Grab a different Dr. P.H. Martin color. I got a pen cleaner. Black, of course. Maybe we'll just grab some watercolor for now. Yeah, I love the Zipitone too. I really got into screen printing for a little while, and I wanted to get as much done in one color or two colors as I could, and so that's definitely influenced the stuff I've done later on. There's just a nice look to black and white artwork with the halftones on it. It's like those old school comic artists, like if you can't make it work in black and white, if it doesn't work in black and white, I don't know if the color will do a lot for it. Although, color can fix a lot of the artwork, like inking can. But the stuff I grew up on was the detail and texture, and a lot of the information was in the inks, and that's the type of artwork I still like a lot. Let's see. Here's some of the stuff that already exists. So my watercolor palette from before. It's nice to have this artwork done and just worry about the colors, because I'm just kind of riffing. Don't know what this is going to end up looking like, but I'm going to have some fun getting there. I'll figure it out. It's always white out, correction fluid, or drawn back over it with ink. There's always some solutions. Another thing I love about watercolors, you get those strong, bold ink lines and put some watercolor over it, they're perfectly compatible. They don't really overpower each other, which I like a lot. Let's see. Snooze over here. She does a good job of being a studio dog. Thank you. pretty fun. I've been saying he forgot what the secret word to win a to potentially win a free copy of the new Walking Dead book. I believe it was the name of my studio dog named Tootsie. Let's see if we can get anybody else in there. I saw a couple people put it in there. So we'll definitely have a winner, which is exciting. This is a good example of some guitar in a track. Not any kind of crazy guitar, but I think it works for what it is. Very simple guitar, actually. F09 is trying to watch, but now he's got to do work. I understand the dilemma. Which is why it's kind of nice this year. Kind of cleared my schedule to do some. Enjoy working on some stuff. Keep things simple. Thanks, Brain. Appreciate all the positive feedback I can get. Hope you enjoyed watching what you could. Pulling some yellow back in, Martin will like this. Because now I have pink and yellow. Primary color scheme going on. I dig it. Primary colors with magenta replacing red, which I'm a fan of. Yeah, that's fun. I feel like they need a moon or something behind it. Maybe when this is dry, I'll go back in and use my Velita white number two. Let's put a moon in that background. I just feel like sometimes composition just needs a circle. Let's see if I've got a lighter view. One thing I like about alcohol markers is a big blend, which is kind of nice. It's almost like having watercolor in a marker. And then, of course, there are now watercolor markers. Still looks pretty good on screen. Sometimes I'm worried by going too far in that direction, it might ruin it, but there's always a way to bring it back and save it. So the space is dry here. I don't know, that might be as far as we want to go with the colors right now. I'll let that dry. Got some other zombie stuff kicking around as well. This is pretty zombie-like. We could do something with that. Oh yeah, I put some stuff underneath it too. We got a guy wearing a sombrero playing a guitar with another zombie. Got all kinds of stuff in here. Let that dry. Another zombie stuff is over. This is pretty fun. I never finished this, but this looks good. We'll jump into this. This is a piece with some gouache. Let's see. It looks like I was unhappy with the details of the face. Let's try and build back in. We don't need any reference. We'll just make it up. Thank you. nice about gouache is it makes a nice surface to work other materials into as well. I mean, I guess acrylic does the same thing, potentially. I don't know, there's a little bit, gouache is a little chalkier. Provides a little bit better of a surface that I prefer to work on a little bit more. I forgot how much I like to work on this stuff. It's nice to just work on one image sometimes, as opposed to, so it feels like a million sequential images. At some point I will probably do a fully painted comic. How long that comic is will be another discussion. It's not going to be 100 pages, I can tell you that. Is one of those things where you can get away with a lot. Okay, I'm gonna break out some gouache. What time are we at even? 3:41. Flying through today. Thank you. wash is sold. It's all dried out.
There you go.
Way too much of the color I wanted, but that's alright. At least I got it. Evan and I were talking about a Doctor Strange pitch where he's basically the Crypt Keeper in an anthology of different stories. This guy here, he's kind of a zombie hipster. What would he play? He'd probably just be kind of annoying. Might just like hang around the Sanctum Sanctorum where Doctor Strange is and tell Doctor Strange about all these great shows he was at, and Doctor Strange is kind of not interested because he's got other things to do.